said, do me a favor. I said, do me a favor.
Yes, sir.
I said, do me a favor.
Father, your word declares.
who has loved God, loved his family, and has been an example within our community. I realize the word tells us that we are to weep at the coming in, that we ought to rejoice at the going out. For our Lord Jesus the Christ, he emphasized, seek first the kingdom of God in all of his righteousness. As we celebrate the life of our brother, our friend, to many who were husband, who was father, who was uncle, we celebrate his life. To some, he was employer, co-laborer. But we are going to celebrate because we realize there is victory in Christ Jesus. We don't worship as people who don't have a hope. We have a blessed hope. And the Bible, it informs us that we all shall take off that which is corruptible and put on that which is incorruptible. And so we agree with the word of God on this hour. And as we prepare to celebrate, we want to welcome all our guests and friends and all of you who are of the cloth, some of our apostles and our bishops and our awesome pastors that are here, some of our state representatives, our senators that are here, our commissioners, our mayors that are here, friends and family, and there are numerous organizations that are here, all of the funeral directors from all over the state that are here, those that are part of the Slingshot Club that are here, your classmates here, neighbors and friends. We welcome you as we celebrate the life of a friend and a brother. We don't take it lightly, but we are going to lift him up before God because he was worthy. He was worthy. And so though we weep, and we're going to weep, there is always a weeping with a separation. It is natural. We all are going to miss him, and it's okay, because separation hardens the heart sometimes. And so as we celebrate, we are going to stay on our program here on this hour. You may be seated in his presence. We're going to have a scripture reading from Pastor Gerard Duff from Rising Star Missionary Baptist Church here in Griffin. If you would come at this time, Pastor.
Amen. Our scripture reading comes from the book of Psalms. Psalm 23. The psalmist penned these words to help us in moments like this. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest me, oh, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Beloved, in the New Testament, we are given hope from John, the writer of the book of Revelation. In Revelation chapter, beginning at verse 1, John pens these words. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth passed away, and there was no longer any sea. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, made ready as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is among men, and he will dwell among them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be among them, and he will wipe away every tear from their eyes. And there will no longer be any death. There will no longer be any mourning or crying or pain, for the first things have passed away. Amen.
Amen. We pray that you will receive the blessing that is in the reading of his holy scripture. We will have our prayer of comfort by Pastor Eric Cooley from a Newcomb and Sea Church in Port Gibson, Mississippi. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the life, the legacy, and the love of Terrence Rashad Dorch. And Father, as we come today, we come lifting up the Williams and Dorch family. We come lifting up the employees of Dorch, Williams, and Mortuary, all the friends and all the family. Father, you are the God of all comfort. So we declare in the name of Jesus that your comfort be made known in this place today. Lord, in all that's said and done, you alone be glorified. Father, we thank you and we give you praise and we give you glory, Father, for what you have done in our midst and what you will continue to do. We thank you, Father, that in the days, weeks, and months to come, your hand continue to be upon the family, upon his mother, upon his brother. Father, we thank you right now for his life. We thank you for his legacy. And we thank you for moving in this service. Holy Spirit, have your way in this place. In the name of Jesus. Father, many hearts are heavy. Many questions, why, Lord, but Lord, even in this, we trust you. As Job said, though you slay me, yet will we trust you. So Father, we trust in you that in this day, you will continue to give us hope. And we don't grieve as those who have no hope, but we look for the blessed hope of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for all that will be said and done today, and we thank you that Jesus Christ will be glorified. It's in the mighty master's name of Jesus that we pray, and by his blood, and all that agree, shout amen. Amen and amen. And this will be followed by a special tribute from the niece, Miss Bethany O'Neill. A few will come at this time. Amen. We are so grateful for family and the connection that is within family. And family is so important in the establishment of purpose, and it helps us maintain our journey. Amen.
Good morning. Like you said, I am the proud niece of Katrina and Terrence Dorch. And this morning, I want to share words with you that will not only bring you comfort, but encourage you to cherish the time that you spend with your loved ones. This week has been filled with so many stories of how people met my uncle, and I love hearing them because I don't really ever actually remember meeting him. He was just always there. Even before he was my uncle and he was just Mr. Terrence, he was there for my family the same. And my uncle wasn't a man of many words, but our exchange was always so simple. Since I was a little girl, he would see me and he'd say, Bet, bet, and I would say, hey, Uncle Terrence, and we would hug, and he would go do his thing, and I would go do mine. And he had the uncle role down pat. I mean, he was there to talk when needed, and he provided comic relief all the time. He knew exactly what to say. And he also had those holy handshakes down real good, too. So, and he was, but the most important thing that I loved about my uncle is the way that he loved my auntie and the way that he loved my cousin TP. And he's also responsible for the coolest 9-year-old I know, so. I just love seeing him care for my family, and he made us feel like a family even before we were. So when they got married, it was just business as usual. And I want to share my favorite memory with him. It's a couple years back in 2020. We were staying at a house for Deuce's birthday, and my uncle had brought the slingshot up there. And at this point, I was the only one who had never ridden in the slingshot. And so he was like, come on, Bebe, we gonna take a ride. And it was a little late. And my auntie, she's a worrier. So she was like, well, where are y'all going? And what time y'all gonna be back? And he was like, don't worry, we just going around the corner. We did not just go around the corner. we ended up going downtown, and we were just riding, and we were vibing, and he was listening to Polo G. He was showing me all the music he was listening to, and it was just a good time. And that journey was unexpected, and I've lived this life long enough to know that life will take you to some unexpected places. And this loss is so unexpected, but we have to cherish the time that we have and look to those who we share this journey with and hold on to them now even more than ever. And so I was lucky, we were all lucky enough to share this journey with Uncle Terrence this far. And in his absence, I just hope that we can hold on to each other and love each other even more. Thank you.
Amen. You know, so many of us have had so many awesome, awesome experiences and encounters, and we are to remember those. We are to remember those joyous moments. Those are eternal moments that we will have forever until we meet our Creator ourselves. And so let's cherish every single moment. Well, I just want to remind you, back in the country, there was this old deacon. And he was on the floor praying right before the service. And as he got on his knees to pray, he began to say some things that was a little bit curious to many. And he said, I hate buttermilk. And the other deacons just looked at him. And he kept on praying. And then he said, I hate flour. And they looked at him continuously. And then he said, I really don't like lard either. And the deacon kept on praying. But he got to the end of his prayer, but he said, I love biscuits. And sometimes in life, we don't understand the parts that takes place of what must goes into something that we love. We don't understand the moment. But after the mixing and the baking, it becomes something that we can really adore. And so we don't understand this moment right now, but after the mixing and the baking, I think we're really gonna enjoy it in the end, because the gospel says in Jeremiah 29:11, I know the plans that I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a future and a hope. God has a plan for our life, and I hope you're still optimistic about what God desires to do in our life. Well, at this time, we're gonna have a selection from Glorious Praise Chorale from the awesome Global Impact Christian Ministry out of Stockbridge. Open up your heart and celebrate as they worship and give God glory.
Up as a sign of surrender unto the Father, and even with your hands lifted, can you open your mouths and begin to release worship unto Father? We love you. You're wonderful and you're good. You're mighty and you're majestic. You're awesome. There's nobody like you. And even in this moment, we worship you. We magnify you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. Hallelujah. Oh. Abundantly above all you could ask.
Amen. I hope you really believe that. That God is able. He is able to do abundantly above all that we ever ask or think. We don't just believe in God. We trust God. We take Him at His word. God is faithful unto the end. Glory to God. I tell you what, Pastor O'Neill, they did you a wonderful service as they sung right here. Glory to God. Amen. We thank God for glorious praise chorale. We're going to have reflections at this time, and we have a designated list of those that have been chosen to give reflections. And for the sake of time, you know, we can only allow but so many, and we really want to honor the program. And we would just kindly ask that if you could stay within the time frame that has been allotted for you, as we honor the family, they're just asking for you for a couple of minutes to actually reflect. And we realize that you have so many memories and so many testimonies that you would like to share. And there are others who have testimonies and encounters they would like to share. I would encourage you to do this. Sit down, take a pen, write down what Terrence meant to you, the role that he played in your life. Put it to pen and mail it to them so they will have your memory as well, so that you too can participate in this awesome, awesome celebration. Well, first is coming up is Deacon Clifford Meeks, the uncle. If you would come at this time, Deacon Meeks, if you could please come at this time. Oh, here he comes. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to that name, Jesus the Christ. Amen. And, you know, as we celebrate life, you also introspect. Always introspect when you're celebrating life. What kind of a person can I become? What kind of person can I become? What have I not lived up to? This is your moment. Use it as a stepping stone. Come, sir.
Good morning. Good afternoon. Dream is going to be all right. When I got the call, and I said, Lord, here we are again. And when my niece asked me to have a few remarks, I said, okay, how could you say no? And as much as I try to pin something, the Lord wouldn't allow it. And He said, go from your heart. Terrence, as all of our nephews are, and nieces, are like our own children. But as Beth said, Terrence was one that didn't have many words to say. But there was one incident, one thing that I think the family can remember, one loving time. Terrence got to know us real well. But then when my wife and I celebrated our 50th anniversary, we asked them to come and everything, and Terrence did. And Terrence reminded us, and I brought up the event, that he didn't know that his aunt, my wife, could even drive, much less not even have a car. She showed up one time at the funeral home, I believe, and he couldn't believe that Uncle Cliff wasn't driving her. But be that as it may, Terrence was one that lived life fully. And as we communicated and as we talked, I noticed Terrence lived life good and There's a poem that says about the dash. And you know, most of you heard it. You have the time that you were born. Then there's that dash. Then the time that you die. But what's more important is that little dash. How you live your life. So that when the time comes, our people are saying good things. They are saying all the good that you did, all the things that you helped people, how you helped people, how you did the things that the Lord had wanted you to do and had assigned you to do, rather than wondering what to say. Terrence had a purpose, and he fulfilled it. There's nothing to be ashamed of in the life that Terrence lived. My nephew was always on point. And I would talk to him about that. I'm an old Vietnam veteran, and I would talk to him about being on point. And he would always be on point. And he said, "Unc, you got it?" I said, "As long as you're on point." So, yeah, we're going to miss Terrence, but his legacy will live on. We'll always know that he loved his family, he loved his wife, he loved his kids, he loved his whole family with the love that it's hard to find nowadays. The love and respect that means the world to you goes from heart to heart, from breast to breast. So when life's over, you know that you live well and you can hopefully go on and hopefully hear the master say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things, just a few things. Come on up. I'll make you ruler over many. Rule on, Terrence."
Amen, amen, amen. And as we continue, we are going to have reflections from Reverend Darlene Bolden. If you're here, come at this particular time. Darian Bolden. Reverend Darian Bolden, who is a cousin. And I'm going to ask the remainder of those that are going to have reflections, if you could come and stand at the steps here and be prepared to come as the person that's preceding you complete. And that is Mr. Keter Little, his childhood friend, and then there's Mr. Thomas Earl Darsh III, which is his brother, and which will be followed by Mr. Ricky Lamar Clark, the City of Jonesboro City Manager, and followed by the Honorable Khalid Kaman, Mayor of South Fulton, and Commissioner DeMont Davis. Wherever you are, if you could, the closest steps to you, if you'll be prepared to come so that we can keep moving expeditiously. Amen.
And the people of God said, amen. Thank you, Trina, for this opportunity to say just a few words about our younger cousin. Two aunts were pregnant at the same time. One gave birth in February, the other gave birth in June. Terrence came in February, and I tell you, he fulfilled his purpose. Those things that God had slated for him to do, he did it. And I just bring greetings from all of the family in Jacksonville to let you all know that we love you. We're praying your strength in the Lord. I was here either last year or the year before. We all got together, Terrence, Tommy, and I, and a friend of mine. He wanted to be here, but due to some illness, he was not able to make it. But Junior and I, we came on up in spite of everything that's going on. We wanted to be here to show our love for Terrence and thank God for his life and the work that he has done. I always complimented him on Facebook when I saw him out doing community service, because he had that type of spirit of giving back. I'm an old Chicago Bulls fan. Michael Jordan's last championship series, they brought in, during one of the last games, they brought in an extra cameraman. And this cameraman's job was just to keep the camera on mic. The commentators were talking because they were watching him, because they know the object of the camera people is to keep the eyes on the ball, or to keep the camera on the ball. But this particular cameraman kept his camera on mic. When the game was over, they were able to catch up with this cameraman and question him and say, the cameraman's job is to keep the camera on the ball, but we noticed you kept the camera on mic. He said, yeah, they hired me in as an extra. Say, well, why did you keep the camera on mic and not on the ball? He said, well, my job was to keep the camera on mic because around the end of the game, Mike has been known to do something. Terrence, my cousin, has always been known to do something. And so we thank God for his life. We thank God for his family. And he loved family. He talked about family and he exemplified it. He loved this job. This was what he loved doing. But guess what? One of these days, if the Lord delays his coming, we all have to come this way. God bless you.
Amen, amen, amen. Because it is appointed to all of us a day that we all must make the transition. Because the Bible says that when we see him, we shall be like him. Amen. Well, following again, it's Mr. Kedar Whittle, who's a childhood friend, and then will be followed by Thomas Earl Darsh III, which is his brother.
Woo! Word. There we go. How's everybody? Y'all couldn't tell me this was gonna be it. Yeah, y'all couldn't tell me this was gonna be it. Okay, there we go. All right. I got note cards. I can't go off earth. 40-some years of memories up here. It'd be more than 2 minutes. He always used to say, one time for the one time. One time for the one time. He picked the coldest day in the last 5 years. One time for the one time. That's it. He was a cold, cool cat. That's what it was for the cold day. It always happened to the good ones, too. Terrence was a good one. I got about 5 people in my life right now I'd gladly trade for Terrence. We all got at least 3 in here. Tweezy. Dunny Crow had a vision. I remember being in the 4th grade. Don't worry, I'm not gonna go 4th grade to now. Don't worry, I'm gonna skip some years. I remember the 4th grade, we was in Ms. Jones' class at Collier Heights, and we had to pick our profession of what we wanted to do. Obviously, doctor, lawyer, teacher, fireman, firefighter, all that stuff was up there. Terrence said, mortician. 4th grade, first of all, we was like, what is that? Because we in the 4th grade. Second of all, bro, you want to work with dead people? That's what you want to do? But he did it. And he did it well. And as you can see, this is what came out of it. Now we see the vision. I remember when I was coming back to L.A., coming back from L.A. every time. And this is pre-Uber. Terrence would pick me up from the airport. And every single time, he would have on a suit. clean. Had about three of them. You switch them out, rotate. Change the socks and the watch band. You think it's a whole new suit. And I don't care where we going. He gonna have that suit on all the time. He had a vision. He would say, hey, nah, I'm gonna wear this suit every day so the whole South Side know who I am. And I don't care where you go on the South Side, they know who Mr. Dorch is. He was a giver. At least 10 people in here, family members, got buried on the Lolo. You know what I'm saying? To bring your $2,500 up here, you just better tell the next three of your people they gotta come see me. Don't tell them the price, tell them come see me. The crazy thing about it, even when he gave you a discount, he didn't treat you like he gave you a discount. He treated you like family, because that's who Terrence was. I remember Kyrie was playing, started playing football. And I said, hey man, Kyrie playing football. He said, Vic, shoot me the schedule. Terrence not only was a giver of his money, but he was a giver of his time. He called me after football practice, said, the boys need a lot of work, go ahead and go back. Every Saturday for you, dog. I said, that's my boy. Tommy, you ain't got to do it by yourself, bro. Terrence held it down. You ain't got to hold it down. You got brothers that got your back. Mama, you raised me. Just like you had Terrence on speed dial, you put me on speed dial. Because Tommy and Jennifer might be in Dubai riding the camels, screaming YOLO, taking selfies. You over here trying to get to the doctor, you don't even know where he is. Call me. I'm gonna be down there next week. Make sure all your neighbors got my number. Trina, you got a tribe around you. I'm talking about, I ain't seen nobody. They was there from 4 a.m. the morning up. I don't even think they left. They made all their clothes, washed their underwears in the sink because they ain't want to leave your side. That's a real team right there. Everything they can't do, your brothers got your back. Everything. You ain't got to do it by yourself. Deuce, TP, godson, nephew. TP, we have already had our talk. I have already seen you step up and move into action, young man. I am proud of you, and Terrence is too. Deuce, light-skinned goddaddy, dark-skinned goddaddy. Boy, when I say we got you, we won't be able to be there in the house and have that everyday movement and inspiration like Terrence. But we will be there anytime you need us. We will also be there even when you don't know you need us. We got you. To the staff, y'all know what it is. Y'all know what he would already say. Amen. It's the house of the Lord. But y'all know, things gotta keep moving. Family, friends, community. Let's let this legacy continue. Be kind to each other. Be generous to each other. Live, love, and lead with grace. Create the vision. Make it plain. Do it your way, just like Terrence did it the Dorch way. If you have been blessed by Terrence, from St. Paul's to Kaya Heights to North Clayton to Burdett, Old National, Smoking Room, Slingshot Crew, High Five I, Circuit City. He's been a lot of places. Through the family, if you know Terrence and he has blessed your life, please raise your imaginary glass of communion juice. If he done bought you a drink, if he done helped you with your rent, a light bill or something, we gonna say one time for the one time. On the count of three. One, two, three. One time for the one time. Love you, baby.
Amen. That demonstrates the longevity of that relationship to have that many experiences is to know someone that well in life. Amen. Amen. Well, we will still follow the program here, and next is coming up is Thomas Earl Darch, the third brother. Amen. Thank you.
One time for the one time. So good afternoon. My name is Thomas Earl Darch, the third, and I am the very proud brother of Mr. Terrence Rashard Darch. Terrence Rashard Darch was a solid gentleman. Google describes the word solid as being made of strong material, well grounded, reliable, and good to others. Terrence Darch had a divine calling to where he was always good with others. From the many families that he served on their time of bereavement, or whether it was him motivationally speaking at a career day at one of the local schools, or his involvement in the many activities that he stood for to empower the communities that he served as a pillar. Solid. His unselfishness and unconditional love for people was always done with the utmost sincerity and compassion. He would always say, "Hey bro, I'm just a kid from College Park." And my answer was, "That grew up to be the people's champ." Solid. A loving husband to his wife, dedicated father to the boys, and to each and every one that had the honor to claim him as a friend. Was a true friend indeed. If you know Terrence, you know that he was big on family and big on family tradition. But he used to always say, "Hey bro, you know where that comes from? That comes from well-grounded parents." Amen to that. And through him growing up, there were very many instrumental people in his life, whether it was teachers, educators, coaches. They all instilled in him the values that he took to heart, which was integrity, accountability, respect. And last, but probably the first on his list, is goodwill towards other people. Solid. A man about his business. He took a dream, and him and Trina turned the dream into a reality. That reality Ben sparked a vision. And then that vision gave birth to a legacy, George Reeves. And, you know, and make no mistake about it, the legacy didn't end last week when Terrence expired. The legacy won't end after these services today. But the legacy starts today. So, to God be the glory for my brother, Mr. Terrence Rashard George. Solid.
Coming up is Mr. Ricky Clark, which is the City of Jonesboro City Manager. If you will come at this time.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Collin Park, Clay County. Good afternoon. I never thought in a million years that I would have to endure this moment. Actually, I was just going through the program, and there's a picture in there when I celebrated my 35th birthday last year. And one of the things I told Terrence was, you know, I want people to see me doing stuff in the community too. So I was turning 35, and he challenged me to give away $35,000. Well, the first sponsor of the event, of course, was Terrence Dorch, and we, in fact, raised over $65,000. That just goes to show how his legacy will live on. And the saddest part about that moment was he said that night, Ricky, if you can celebrate your birthday like this, since this was my idea, you have to get me a proclamation from the City of Jonesboro. And while I fell short to do it just 1 year ago, there was no way I could come here today to issue a proclamation without him being able to receive it himself with one of those fancy suits and that wooden bow tie. So instead, I decided to do a tribute, a special letter to his family, the descendants of Mr. Terrence Dorch, commemorating his legacy and what he actually meant to me. And it reads as follows. From the Office of the City Manager of Jonesboro, Ricky O. Clark Jr., December 23rd, 2022. Dear family, you see, Terrence, known by most as Dorch, was more than anything we could ever imagine in life. His ties to the community and the inner operations of government ran deep. You see, when I didn't know anyone in Clayton, I met Terrence. While my mind was still in figuring out who everyone was, with the major funeral homes that were located in my community, to the major businesses that were trying to relocate here, I really yearned just for the opportunity for someone to be truthful about who these people were in Clayton that I was dealing with. Terrence, an amazing husband, a father, a son, our friend, never had any issue telling your city manager the truth about who the people of Clayton County actually were. Jesus, if I could only tell some of the stories. In fact, he ended up being one of the most supportive people to me during my tenure as city manager for this city. Oftentimes I would ask, why in the world are you so genuine? But it was simple. His life was built around building up the next generation of leaders and community givers. When we opened the first black restaurant in downtown Jonesboro, he and his wife were the table that I selected to sit right next to me as we commemorated that moment. When funeral home directors and morticians from across the state contacted my office about opening up a crematory right there in our city, funeral home directors, Terrence Dorch was the only one who brought me into his funeral home to show me, in fact, what a crematory actually was. That is a day I will never forget. In fact, I'll tell you, he was actually cremating a body and wanted to show me all of how it worked. But you see, funeral home directors, if it wasn't for that education, that lesson that he showed me that day, there would be no way that a crematorium would open up on this side of time. See, when I decided to venture into business on my own because I wanted the fancy cars and the slingshot just like he had, I told him, Terrence, I think I'm starting a mask business. If it's COVID and everyone is wearing a mask, I'm creative and I can make it. My first customer was Terrence Dortch. While the first seems to be a recurring theme in this letter, it's because when you Google the definition of first, you will find that the definition means foremost in position, rank, or importance. So yes, we shall forever remember the first place that Terrence played in our lives. When we wake up in the morning, the first thing we'll think about is the difference that Terrence made in so many lives. Family members, when you think about the long days ahead, remember all of us here will be the first people to help you out. And to all that bear his legacy, let us be the first to carry it on. And when the days ahead seem dreary, may this letter remind you of all of the firsts that Terrence left with us all ahead. Your city manager, to my brother, Ricky L. Clark, Jr. Thank you.
To the family, my sympathies go to you. I've only known Terrence a short time, about 4 or 5 years. And Ricky can attest to that, one thing I don't do is wear ties. And Terrence had an impact on me while I wore a tie that day. Now I'm gonna get in the car and tear it right off, but I had to do that. Now, which one is Deuce? Deuce, you got your dark skin back there and you got your light skin. But let you know, you got Clayton County government too. All right. So if anything step out, you let us know. We want to give the family a proclamation. My folks did not give me my 20 point fine letter to read, so I'm struggling. Ricky Clark, come on up here.
Now, if Terrence were here, he would tell you, no, you should have brought your glasses, Commissioner. The proclamation reads, Clayton County Board of Commissioners expresses heartfelt condolences to the family of Terrence Dortch. December 23rd, 2022. And whereas Terrence Rashard Dortch was born in Atlanta, Georgia on February 9th, 1979 to the late Thomas Dortch of Atlanta, Georgia and Evelyn Davis Dortch of Yulee, Florida, and was raised in the Ponderosa community of College Park. And whereas Terrence Dortch was baptized in the Catholic Church, his early education started at St. Paul of the Cross Catholic School in the College Park, Georgia, a community of Southwest Atlanta, and he began his education at Collier Heights Elementary School, followed by attendance at North Clayton Middle School and graduating from Douglas High School in 1997. And whereas Terrence Dortch's career was influenced by witnessing what he considered to be the ultimate display of business professionalism demonstrated by a local funeral home that handled the funeral of his late grandmother at Union Baptist Church. And whereas Terrence Dortch attended Fort Valley State University, then his calling led him to Gupton Jones College of Funeral Services, where he received an Associate of Science in Funeral Service degree in 2005. While attending Gupton Jones, Terrence began his funeral career as an apprentice and funeral assistant at Williamson Mortuary. And whereas Terrence Dortch fulfilled his dream of owning and managing a funeral home as the founder and CEO of Dortch Williamson Funeral Services and Cremation in Riverdale, Georgia. And whereas Terrence Dortch served the community by giving away groceries, gas and toys, donating to food and clothing drives, assisting those affected by disasters and the pandemic, and was presented many awards and honors for his free spirit of giving and community involvement. His most recent accomplishment was being a 2022 inductee of the Old National Hall of Fame. And whereas Terrence Dortch went home to be with the Lord on December 14, 2022, he leaves his loving wife, Ventrina Dortch, two sons, Thaddeus and Terrence Deuce II, mother, Evelyn Davis Dortch, brother, Thomas Earl Jennifer Dortch III, mother-in-law, Betty Brown Williamson, sister-in-law Pastor Colita O'Neill, nephew Spencer O'Neill II, niece Bethany O'Neill, and a host of other loving relatives, staff, and friends to cherish his memory now.
Now, therefore, I, DeMont Davis, Commissioner on behalf of the Clayton County Board of Commissioners, on this day, December 23rd, 2022, express its sincere sympathy and heartfelt condolence on the passing of this community servant, whose death is a profound loss to his family, friends, and this Clayton County community. The Clayton County Board of Commissioners causes this resolution to be sent to the family as a mark of respect and in honor of the memory of Terrence Dorch. Thank you. I'd like to say to you, Deuce, as long as you keep your eyes on the Heavenly Father, you will always see your earthly daddy while seeing him.
Amen, amen. We are so grateful for all of our civic leaders who serve in the municipalities here in the county. And you can see the evidence of the interaction and the diligence of Terrence and how he played a role, not just in serving our personal needs in the time of bereavement, but he served the community as a whole. And that makes a big difference as a human being. Amen. Well, next coming up, we have our monks who serve here in Clayton County. They're going to come up. Terrence served them in so many different ways, and he served their community as well. And they're going to come and have some reflections at this time. Amen. Open your heart to receive them.
Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, Christian and friend. I'm Buddhist monk from Tri Ratnaram Temple, Riverdale. I'm always work with Dodge Williamson. He's very good, kind for me and for our community. When I heard he lost, I'm really sad that we different religion, but being human, that I come here for the today is very sad day for us that we lost our beloved person. He was a wonderful grandpa, father, and fantastic husband. And he was respectful, helpful person for our community. First, I would like to offer my heartfelt condolences to you and your family. May Mr. Dodge Williamson so be in at the peace with our Heavenly Father. Second, from my heart, I pray for peace and comfort for you and your loved one. For peace and comfort for you and love one at difficult time, and offer condolences to you all. third shooting this, his body will go away from us a little bit more. But Mr. Lloyd Williamson can tell, shall we be always be in our heart forever? Life is the greatest gift that God has given us. For that, it's only a bridge toward eternal life with the Buddha and God. Certainly, heaven is rejoicing another soul has finally reached his true home. Last but not least, I would like to send a message to everyone. Please live your life a good life by giving happiness to each other, being honest and loyal to each other, and treating other like you want to be treated. I would like to declare all my good deeds that I have done to Mr. Lloyd Williamson. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you, Buddha and God. Stay with Lloyd Williamson. Thank you.
As you can see, he served all of our community. He served all of our community. And amen. And we also have the mayor who is coming at this time.
Thank you. Giving honor to God, who is the head of my life. Pastor Salter is the head of his house. I bring you greetings from Atlanta's new twin city, South Fulton, Georgia. My name is Khalid. I am the mayor, and I am joined by my brother on council, Dr. Mark Baker.
Councilman Emeritus for the city of South Fulton, I just want to say my condolences to the family. Terrence was a brother. Even though we met in a professional level, he was a great guy who was just there for me and the whole community. His last conversation was an invite to the house, the new house. And I mean, one of your brothers, well, your dark-skinned brother actually pointed out that my hand and several other hands should go up because I could call him and say, man, we lost somebody else in the district and I don't know where they're gonna get any money from. And he was like, babe, just give them my number. And I don't know what happened, but I will get a call back of gratitude, and I just have to reach back to my brother. And I know that there's so many people in here that share that same sentiments, and you have my personal number and everything else, and I'll make sure that I'm there in return for your sons in any way that I could possibly be. That's my word. Thank you. One time for one time.
Dorch wasn't just our constituent, he was our friend. And I would not be standing here as mayor if he did not believe in me. Before I read this proclamation, and I won't read the whole thing, I would like for every business person, every businessman and every businesswoman on the South Side to please stand. If you own a business on the South Side, please stand. The thing to know about Dorch is that he didn't keep standing. The thing to know about Dorch is that he didn't just give money willy-nilly to everyone. He did that too, but he invested in the people in our community. He didn't leave. He stayed and he invested in all of us. And if you really want to honor this great man, I want you to look around and make sure that from henceforth and forevermore that you do business with the people that you see standing in this room. We have to do business with one another. We have to keep our dollars circulating in our community. We have to keep investing in one another. That is how we make our community strong, and that is how he made us all strong. And so, to the family, I will give you my card and my number as well. You all, I'm just a phone call away, and I'm just going to read a few of these. Whereas his indefatigable work ethic and service to families and the community in their time of greatest need led Terrence Dortch to become one of Southside's most successful businessmen. Whereas he used his power and resources to pour into his community through countless giveaways of toys, tuition, rent, gas, clothing, and more, investment in dozens of local business ventures begun by his friends, and the employment of formerly incarcerated individuals in South Fulton, fathers in need of a second chance. And whereas for his altruism and accomplishments, Dortch is lovingly remembered by all who encountered him. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the mayor and entire city council of the city of South Fulton do hereby proclaim Thursday, February 9th, 2023, as Terrence R. Dortch Day in the city of South Fulton. Tony Thomas, we got another party to play, sir. South Fulton forever.
Thank you, Mayor. I come to you today as part of what we call the political family. I am Fulton County Commissioner Khadijah Abdulrahman, affectionately known as Commissioner Khadijah. I come here today to celebrate the life of a giant. One only needed to look at the toy drive where even in death, Brother Dortch made sure that children in the community, thousands of children were served a couple of nights ago. And what I say, giving honor to the clergy here, those on the dais, Mama Dortch, and the rest of the family, you shared him with us. But one thing I want to say, because as we know, I'm not always politically correct, but like Brother Dortch, when he met me, because we would have this joke about, you know, I represent for the fluffy sisters. He would call me the Beyonce of politics, and I would call him the Jay-Z of the mortician business. He treated that person that was in the gutter, that person that didn't have a whole bunch of letters behind their name, that person that didn't have triple, quadruple zeros in their accounts, he treated them the same as the person who did. And you can clap for that. In this day and age, many of us obtain what he obtained, but we forget where we came from. He never forgot. Even though the relationship, the friendship was short-lived, I only met him when I got sworn in. But it was nothing that I could not call on him for. And just to be candid with you, to see that bow tie, I was like, oh, I got my Muslim brother with me. Now, he wasn't Muslim. But the fact that I was the first Muslim woman elected to office, he supported me. And that means a lot, because it takes all kinds, all hearts, and all prayers to heal a community. And so I say to you, family, he is a giant, and he lived a life of somebody that was three times his age. He touched so many people. And I would be remiss if I did not at least give the acknowledgments that was sent to my office today. First and foremost, I would like to read the first acknowledgement. To all who have gathered to celebrate the life of Terrence Dortch, please accept my sincere condolences of a beloved community leader that he was. As you gather to celebrate his incredible life, may the memory of his life be a blessing as you share this time to honor his achievements and kind acts of services with all who loved him. His commitment to his family and life of guidance, leadership, and compassion are inspiring, and I am certain that his legacy will continue to lift the communities he embraced. My prayers are with you during this time. Keep the faith. Sincerely, Reverend Raphael Warnock, United States Senator. To the family of Terrence Dortch, on behalf of the office of Congresswoman Nikema Williams and on behalf of the Georgia 5th Congressional District, please allow me to extend my deepest condolences for the passing of Terrence Dortch. Terrence Dortch lived a life of service to the people in the metro Atlanta area and beyond. Terrence was a businessman who created a legacy of caring for others and the environment he lived in. Terrence devoted his time to giving back, encouraging others, and overall bettering his community, employees, and loved ones. Losing a loved one is always difficult. I would like for you to know that my thoughts and prayers are with you. May the memories of Terrence help you find peace and comfort. I pray that you and your family find the strength to overcome this tough time. His commitment to others will live on through the lives he has impacted, as well as through his wife and two beloved sons. I am praying for your courage and strength to help you through this loss. Please accept my sincerest condolences. Please let my office know if there is anything that I can do for you during this difficult time. Yours in service, Congresswoman Nikema Williams. Dear Dortch family, I hope this letter finds you well in such an unfortunate circumstance. We are deeply saddened by the sudden passing of such a wonderful and bright man. Terrence brought life and light with him and everywhere he went. He always made everyone's day at least a little bit brighter with his innate talent of brightening up the world with simply being there. He will sorely be missed, and we will be praying for you. May God bless you in this terrible time, and may we feel his presence with us as he makes his journey to a place to be with his Lord. Please let my office know if there's anything that can be done for you or your family. Sincerely, Senator Donzella J. James. And in closing, I want to say to the family, especially Deuce, you got your light skin, you got your dark skin, you got your Clayton County Commission, and you got your Fullerton County Commission too. So understand, you are the epitome of a father who did everything for everybody, even though he never received the accolades a lot of times. So we all got your back. Let me say this to you, family, not to belabor the point, but it's very important that you all know at Fullerton County what we're doing. This is a proclamation. I will not read everything, but I will tell you this. 100 years from now, if someone goes in and look for this, it'll be there. This is part of the legislative record, and it is the highest recognition at a county level in Fullerton County for a civilian. Whereas Terrence Rashard Dortch was born in Atlanta, Georgia on February 9th, 1979 to Thomas Dortch and Evelyn Dortch, and was raised in Collet Paul. It's not College Paul. They call it Paul. Now, I'm from Atlanta, and I can say that. College Paul. No, seriously, no, College Paul. And of course, he was educated in the Fulton County school system, whereas in Douglas High, and of course, we know that great Fort Valley University. He significantly was influenced to pursue a career in the funeral services by witnesses the dignity and professionalism of his grandmother's funeral at Union Baptist Church. This sparked him. Whereas Terrence joined Global Impact Christian Ministries in 2010, and in 2011, he married his life partner, Katrina Williamson Dorch, and continued to work in funeral services together until 2015, when they stepped away to create a plan for Terrence to have his own funeral home, Dorch Williamson Funeral and Cremation Services in Riverdale, Georgia. And whereas Terrence was very active in his community, sponsoring several football, basketball, and other projects, as well as participating in many career days, he volunteered countless hours, assisted and led many tour drives, food and clothing drives, assisted citizens affected by fires, natural disasters, and other community activities. He has been presented with many awards and honors for his free spirit of giving, most recently being inducted, of course, into the Old National Hall of Fame class of 2022. And whereas Terrence's greatest accomplishments was his role of husband, father, and the love of his life, Katrina, and the father of his loving sons, Thaddeus and Terrence the second, AKA Deuce. Now therefore be it resolved that the Fulton County Board of Commissioners recognizes a well life lived by Terrence Dorch, a life of integrity and service to his entire community, and does hereby proclaim Friday, December 23rd, 2022, as Terrence Rashad Dorch Remembrance Day in Fulton County, Georgia. Thank you. Be blessed, family. We appreciate the love and the sharing that you did with Terrence. Thank you.
Into his presence. And the next voice you will hear will be Dr. Dallas C. Wilson.
Something right to say one time for one time. So we sing this last song. Come on, let's worship the Lord together. Hallelujah. You are way made, miracle word, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Oh, miracle word, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Come on, let's lift it together. You are way
maker, miracle word, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Come on, all of the room, just lift your voices. You are
way miracle word, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You are here, moving in our midst, and we worship you, we worship you. You are here, Father, the one who said, you are the way, way,
miracle.
That's it. Light in the darkness. You're my God. That is who. Oh, my. Come on, one more time. You are the way, way, miracle working. Promise to my God, that is who I am. And I'll forever tell the world you are
waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
I want somebody to give our great God a great praise.
To your God in this atmosphere. Come on.
Hallelujah.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And for this, God, I will bless you. I will give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. I honor the great leadership of this house, Pastor Salters, and the great people of Light of Joy. Would you help me celebrate God? Come on. I've been here several times. I was just sitting up in the balcony. But I'm grateful to be this close to join with you. To my brother from another mother, this was my guy. We didn't talk every day, but when we talked, we talked. He loved his family with everything within him. He had what I call old man wisdom in a young body. I'm gonna miss our conversations, phone calls, bumping into each other at different Atlanta venues. I do want to point out some of my issues with my friend.
Wherever we went, he never let me pay. And so the first time I was cool with that. Second time, third time, fourth, fifth, and sixth, I think he think I'm broke. He just had a heart for those whom he loved. I believe I met him about 19 years ago. When Matrina wasn't studying him. He put on his gear, went to work. He saw what he wanted. I'm gonna miss you. And I still listen to prayers. Journey with me just for a few moments. There is a scripture that I would love to lift to you. Follow me, Job chapter 23, verse 8. It simply reads this: behold, I go forward, but he's not there. And backward, but I cannot perceive him. And on the left hand, where he usually works, but I cannot behold him. He hideth himself on the right hand, that I cannot see him. But he knoweth the way that I take. And when he hath tried me, I shall come forth as pure gold. I need to talk to you for a few fleeting moments from the topic, what to do when you don't know what to do. Speak that to your neighbor, tell him, neighbor, what to do when you don't know what to do. Every now and then we want to believe that we know everything. That everything is just going to work in your favor, but when something happens in your life, storms come that are bigger than we are. They are stronger than we are. They arrive without our permission, like an unwanted guest that knows your address. Storms come to bully us out of our norm, and they come and they stay too long. They are destructive, and storms render us helpless to a force that's greater than ours. Life never made us a promise, but God did. Storms come to shake believers. The first storm songs was the Diluvian, but Psalms 24 and 1 says, the earth is the Lord's and all that's in it, the world and those who live in it, for he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. What's giving me help now is to know that God is still in control. Life comes with very few instructions, and most opt out as they go. God seldom asks our opinions, though does he share the menu and warns us that everything is available to you, but everything is not good for you. Life does not last forever. I don't know who you sit next to, but just turn them and tell them life don't last forever. Some of the longest living fishes are jellyfish. They live for 30 years. The Greenland shark, 200 years. The bowhead whale, 200 years. There's an ocean quagg snail, they said lives 400 years. But for us,
about 72. We all suffer from a condition called CA, convenient amnesia, which means that we forget what we ought to remember, but remember what we ought to forget. I'm going to help you now that when you get home, you will understand what I'm talking about. When you get home, I want you to pull out your yearbook and stand in the mirror with your yearbook. And I want you to look at you from high school. Y'all won't talk to me today. And then look at the other person holding the mirror. The two ain't the same no more. Life can seem unfair because we simply forgot that it was a gift from God and it is temporary. Live before you die so you don't die before you live. You are not in control of life. Life did not come with instructions, but the creator, the manufacturer. But we do not like directions, and we convince ourselves that we can do it by ourselves. What do you do when you don't know what to do? Pastor, I must not be as saved as most of these folks because they were celebrating and lifting their hands and all the good words. No, I was angry. I was angry. This is my prayer. My brother kept telling me, and he had this one issue. He would never let you pay. We would talk and talk and talk.
What do you do
when you don't know what to do? Job gives us our life lesson today. Job was the richest man in Uz, and Job loved God, and Job loved his family. But in one day, everything changed. I need you to understand that everything will change in your life at some point in time. Job was the richest man in Uz, and he had everything going on. But out of nowhere, Satan launched an attack, but only by God's permission. It's amazing that Satan had to get permission from God from this attack. Why would God, who loves us, allow Satan to attack us? God wants to see how you're going to act when the ship gets tossed and driven. Some of you got a good stable game, but what do you do when the ship is turning around? Satan tried to get him, but Job kept on running to this place called the hedge.
The hedge was this place
where he could have comfort in the midst of confusion. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Sometimes you've got to find that place where trouble can't find you, and you've got to find that place where people can't harm you, and you've got to find that place where it's just you and God. Satan had a conversation with God, and he told Satan, talking to God, he says, the only reason Job is like that is because you've given him everything. The only reason Job trusts you is because you give him everything and you made him wealthy. But I dare you, God, if you remove your hand from him, I'll make him curse you to your face. And in one day, Job lost everything. He was sitting in his house and his children was having a party. They were getting it in. And while he was there, the children were having a party. All of his children were just going in. Job, Job, while your servants were plowing and with the oxen, the Sabaeans came in and they stole everything and they killed your servants, but I'm the only one left. Job said, oh my, oh my, oh my. And after a moment, another servant came running and he said, Job, 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 God sent fire down and killed all of your sheep, and I'm the only one who escaped to tell you. Wait a second, I just had a calamity. Now I've got another calamity. Oh my, what's going to happen next? Another servant came and said, Job, Job, all of your children were having a party. They had that Hennessy, y'all don't talk to me. And they were at the house, and while they were there, a wind came and crushed everything, and Job, all of your children are gone. What do you do when you don't know what to do? Job lost his money. He lost his children. He lost his relationship with his wife.
Be careful
what you say in the dark, because God will make you pay for it in the light. Satan now begins to put skin lesions on Job. Painful skin disease permitted by God and given to the enemy for access. God wants to see what you're really working with. And Job's wife told him, listen, you're hurting so bad. Why don't you curse your God and die?
Did you hear what she said? She said,
why don't you curse your God and die? Job said, sugar, honey bun, all my life has been good. So why would I falter now? Because the same God that blessed me before is the same God that's resident right now. So I may be going through a storm, but I found out no storm always lasts always. Sometimes the storm storm, you've got to find your way out. Don't feel no waste time. You've got to believe that God brought you this far, not to leave you alone. So here Job is dealing with this unforgiving calamity. His marriage is on the rocks, his children are dead. His body is racking with pain, lesions everywhere. And Job, in my opinion, now went looking for God in the daytime with a flashlight. He's saying, God, no, 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 no. I know you better than this. And if you're putting this on me, it can't be permanent. There's something that you're trying to tell me that I'm just not missing. But what I'm going to do, I'm not going to bother you. I'm just going to wait. So here Job goes looking for God. Chapter 23, verse 8, he says, behold, I go forward, and he's not there.
I look backward,
but I can't see it. He hideth himself on the right hand, that I cannot see it. But he knoweth the way that I take. And when he hath tried me, I shall come out as pure gold. I thought somebody would have hollered right there. You've been going leave you now. What do you do when you don't know what to do? Would you just whisper that to your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, what do you do when you don't know what to do? I've got the remedy for you. Just before I go, what do you do when you don't know what to do? Job chapter 14, verse 14, it says, if a man die, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time, I will wait until my change comes. The first point I need to give you is you need to learn how to wait on the Lord. Would you look down your row and tell somebody, wait on him. There's a miracle coming your way. Wait on him. The Bible says they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall walk and not be weary. They shall run and not faint. Do I have anybody here that's willing to wait on the Lord? Say yes. Touch somebody and tell them, I don't know what you're waiting for, but I've got big plans. Because I serve a big God. And this time next year, you won't see me in the same situation. Because I'm going to wait until my change comes. Say it. Whisper at your neighbor, tell him, wait on him. When Job still didn't get the answer, Job chapter 13, verse 15. Though he slay me, I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Though he slay me, yet will I trust him. I wish I had a few people in here that in the midst of your circumstance, you can open your mouth and say, God, I still trust you. I'm going through hell and high water, but God, I still trust you. I don't have everything that I need, but God, I still trust you. Wait on him. Trust him. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. And lean not to your own understanding. I've got to move, y'all. Job, chapter 1, verse 21. What do you do when you don't know what to do? You wait on it. Because your miracle is on the way. Whisper to your neighbor and tell him, I'm going to wait on it. Then he says, after you wait on him, then you've got to learn how to trust him. Wave your hand if you're going to trust him in this season. But I've got to give you the third verse and get out of your way. Job chapter 1 verse 21. Job said, naked I came out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. I lost everything. My family is gone. But Job said, naked I came out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave me. What I have to say, it says the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. But the last part of the verse says, blessed be the name of the Lord. Here's your chance to shout it here. Look at your neighbor, tell a neighbor, blessed is the name of the Lord. Wait on him, trust him, and learn how to bless his name. Is there anybody here that's willing to open your mouth and give God the best praise that you can? I know you're hurting down on the inside, but when you praise God, God opens doors in your favor. If I could get just a few folks from College Park to wait. It was the late, great Reverend James Cleveland who paraphrases the expressions of life etched out in words. The psalmist says, "For I feel no ways tired, come too far from where I started from." And nobody told us that the roads were going to be easy, but I don't believe he's brought us this far to leave us. Songwriter went on to say that if when you give him the best of your service, telling the whole world that the Savior has come, be not dismayed. The men do not believe you, for the Savior will understand and say, "Well done." Terrence went to Jesus just as he was, tired, weary, weak, and worn. He laid his head upon the Savior's breast, and there found in him a resting place. From earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, we humbly say, "The Father, into thy gracious keeping, we leave you now, thy servant, sleeping. For you see, something happened to my boss man the other day. He shook off this thing called mortal, got wrapped up in this thing called immortality, charted in the cloud and stepped on heaven's elevator. He decided he was going home to live with the Father. Well, Terrence changed his address. His new address now is 111 New Jerusalem Street. That's one for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Spirit." It's at this time now, on behalf of the family, Mr. Terrence, Rashad Dortch, they wish to express their profound thanks to the many sorrowing friends that have come out of your many busy walks of life to share with them on this, their day of bereavement. This family says from the very depths of their hearts, thank you. Family wishes to give a special acknowledgement and appreciation to the Light of Joy Church, to this amazing pastor, Frank Salters. And can we make some noise for our chaplain, the one and only Dr. Dallas C. Wilson? What to do when you don't know what to do? Family says, thank you. Family also wishes to acknowledge that upon recessing from here, we'll make our way to the East Lawn Memorial Park, where we will lay our beloved boss, friend, brother, to rest. But before we leave this place, I must say this. All hail Terrence Dortch, the slingshot guy. All hail Terrence Rashad Dortch, the one that would say common sense isn't so common. All hail Terrence Rashad Dortch, the one that would say just a kid from College Park. All hail Terrence Rashad Dortch, that would always tell us it's always about the bigger picture. Today, we bury his body, but we will not bury his legacy. His legacy shall live on forever. For one last time, if you love him, I want you to make some noise. Take this roof off this building. Clap your hands and give God praise. Sir, well done. Come on, give me better than that. Acknowledge again, we're going to the East Lawn Memorial Park where we're laying our boss to rest. Before we get ready to do that, those of you all that are flower bearers, know who you are. When you are directed, you're going to be told what to do. Everybody else, we would ask that everybody would remain in your seat and where you are until the family fully processes out. But we want to give a special tribute because this is a giant of a man. This is a legend, and we want to give a special tribute. We're going to do so now, this time, to my brother Chris.
ready to process out.
I
Cinematographer credits belongs to Garden View Funeral Chapel Marketing Director Harris All Things Media, LLC.